months away from the midterm elections, a new race-by-race analysis is revealing that a record-breaking 100 women could be elected to the House in 2018. Among them is Maria Elvira Salazar, a Republican running in Florida's 27th congressional district. Salazar has the backing of retiring Congresswoman Ileana Ross-Leighton, who currently holds that seat. And she joins me now live from Miami. Maria Elvira Salazar, thank you so much for being here today.
Wonderful.
I want to start by asking you, Congresswoman Ross-Leighton, who I've covered and played softball with, in fact, many years, she was frankly concerned about the district perhaps tilting away from the Republican Party. What makes you think that you can hold on to it where she was perhaps concerned she wouldn't?
Well, because I am the, you know, Miami, and we have the background, the downtown Miami that belongs to my district number 27. We are the ultimate melting pot, and I am a product of it. You know, we are the Jewish community and the African American community and the Anglo community and the Cuban community and the Nicaraguans and the Central Americans and the South Americans. And you need to know and be part of this community in order to understand it and to represent it, because we know we're going to be part of the House of Representatives. And I am sure that I have the qualifications and the knowledge to understand what my community wants. And I have the guidance and I have the blessing, like you said, of Ileana Ross, that she did a wonderful job for 30 years, a stellar legacy that she's leaving behind. And I pretend to be sort of a seamless transition between her mandate and myself, or her office and mine.
And what is it about, what is the Republican Party doing today that makes you want to be a part of the Republican Party as opposed to being a Democrat?
Well, listen, Hispanic Americans, we share some of the core values that are enshrined in the Republican Party. And I'm sure that sometimes Democrats do not understand that, but that is the truth. We are self-reliant people. We are God-fearing. We're law-abiding. We like low taxes. We don't like government, or we want a small government. We are family-oriented. And those are the values that are enshrined in the Republican Party. Sometimes people do not understand it, but that is why the congressional, South Florida congressional delegation has been and will continue being Republican.
Do you think that this president embodies all of those values that you just laid out?
Well, I think the president is a pretty unconventional guy, and I'm sure that you have been covering that for the last year and a half. So have I. You know, I was a news reporter for 35 years in this town.
Yes, I
but
do know that.
The president is a transformational figure. But I always say to everybody that asks me that question is that we have to see what he does for the country, not so much what he says.
So and does it matter to you that he calls Mexicans rapists? I mean, does the language that he uses about immigrants bother you?
I agree with you that the words that he has used are not very sensitive, but at the same time, I want to remind you that some of the actions that the Democratic Party has had with my community for the last 30 years have been pretty offensive. I'm going to give you two examples. In 2008, President Obama said to a group of Spanish television journalists that we were going to have an immigration reform law the first year of his presidency. And if that would have been the case, and he would have not given all his political capital to Obamacare, we would not be having the mess and the problems that we're having right now with immigration. That, for me, is a very important topic. So you see, number one. Number two, in 1996, President Clinton, you know what he did? He signed Immigration Reform Act. And you know what that does? That gave the legal framework for any administration to separate kids. He did this, the secure communities. So this is not a matter of Democrats or Republicans. When it comes to immigration, everybody's at fault.
If you were elected to Congress, would you vote to build the president's border wall?
I would definitely vote in order to secure the border, because not even the undocumented want to be
But does that mean
illegal.
The wall that the president
that
wants,
means
the big,
any
beautiful
type
wall?
Of, any type of towers or any type of technology or any type of guards or border security that will secure the border, because we do not want El Chapo or his friends smuggling drugs. And we don't— Listen, the undocumented people do not want to be undocumented. That's why we need to reform our immigration system, and we need to give visas to those that are coming to pick up jalapeno peppers in Southern California or to clean toilets in Orlando or in Manhattan, because that is what my people are doing. So they need some type of legality. Yeah. So they can stay here, they can pay taxes, they can contribute with the economy, and they can continue working like they are right now without a criminal record.
Before I let you go, one final question, since you are, as you mentioned, a former journalist.
Yes.
This president has spoken about the press in this country in ways that some people have called Stalinist. He has said that we are the enemy of the people. Do you agree with that, first of all? And what would you say to the president about the press and whether or not they deserve to be defended?
Oh, no, no. The press, we have the best press in the world. I was Central American bureau chief for Univision, so I know the difference between the Latin American press and the American press. And we have very good press corps. So I defend the press because I was one of yours up until January this year. I believe that what happens is that some journalists, they're bad apples in this industry just like in any other. And some journalists, and I'm sure that you agree with this, just do not like the guy. They don't like him on their gut. And that's the problem, that it is not important if we like the person or not. We need to continue doing our job, being impartial, being unbiased, because that way we gain our credibility. And unfortunately, sometimes that's not happening in American mainstream media. But the press we need, always.
I do appreciate that final thought and very
sure.
much, of course, agree. Maria Elvira Salazar, thank you so much for your time tonight. It's great
thank
to
you
see
for
you.
Having we'll me.